Addressing AI system harms. The latest AI systems are very impressive. Large language models, such as ChatGPT, have ushered in a new era of AI systems that are not just generative, they are general, able to provide a fluent response to almost any question you ask. The fact that many generative AI applications are free means that anyone with internet access can do things that most people thought impossible only a year ago. Generative AI might rule the headlines, but other forms of AI are also becoming increasingly accessible to organizations. It's now common for someone wanting to analyze data with the latest AI tools to do this in a few clicks on an MLOps platform. Once data is uploaded, the system automatically trains, tunes, and ranks models without any coding whatsoever. As a result, more businesses across Australia are experimenting with AI applications as ways of solving problems that until recently were thought to be too hard or required an entire team of data scientists and software engineers. As we discussed in the last video, with this explosion of interest comes a range of new and expanded risks to organizations, as well as potential harms to people. That's because organizations are using AI systems in ways that involve and impact people directly. Some of the fastest growing uses for AI systems are for customer service, for marketing, and for recruitment. To use AI systems responsibly, you need to understand potential harms. Identifying potential harms is referred to as an impact assessment. The negative impacts will depend on what the system is trying to achieve, how it is designed, where it is deployed, and who encounters it. To avoid the harms you've identified, and thereby manage the related risks to your business, you need to put in place appropriate controls. HTI's research shows that the majority of potential harms of an AI system come from three sources. First, an AI system can fail to perform as expected. For example, if an autonomous vehicle doesn't accurately identify objects on the road, it can crash and hurt someone. An algorithm that performs well for one group but poorly for another can end up unlawfully discriminating. A system that isn't robust could fail at a critical moment. Without appropriate security measures, your system could inadvertently release private data. All these are different categories of poor performance. An important question to ask is, what are all the ways that this AI system could fail, and what would be the consequences of such a failure? Second, an AI system can be used in ways that deliberately harm people. For example, an employee might use a facial recognition system to invade someone's privacy. If your website claims to show customers the cheapest deals, but you instruct your recommender algorithm to prioritize more expensive offers, you may be misleading your customers and breaching consumer law. A targeted recruitment algorithm might purposely exclude older or younger people in breach of discrimination law. To assess this category of harm, ask yourself, how could someone use this to intentionally cause financial, psychological, or physical damage? Third, even if AI systems perform well and there's no intent to harm, they can still have negative impacts and create risk for your organization. For example, a facial recognition system used in a publicly accessible place can limit people's rights to privacy. A fleet of self-driving vehicles might create congestion when empty. Energy-hungry algorithms used at scale could produce excess amounts of carbon. In many ways, this is the hardest category to address. Managing this category of harm requires you to think about the second-order impacts of your AI system, particularly when used at scale. To understand this best, you might ask yourself, if this application ended up being used by everyone, everywhere, what issues might arise? In the next video, find out what's required of you as a business leader when you're using AI in your business.